நிலங்கள் இன்னும் விடுவிக்கப்படாமல் இருந்தால் இந்த பிரதேசத்துடைய அபிவிருத்தியை மையமாக கொண்டு விடுவிப்பதற்கு நான் ஏற்கனவே உத்தரவிட்டிருக்கிறேன் என்று அறிவித்திருக்கிறேன். அதை நான் இந்த சமயத்திலே மிக நன்றி.
Next item is the presentation, Palali development and ongoing project. While Mahal Singhanti Shraya, Honorable N.A. Sumandiran, Member of Parliament, Honorable Siddharthan, Member of India, Lord Chief Mayor Jaffna, Minister of Transport and Irrigation, District Secretary Jaffna, Chairman Irrigation Authority, Division of Sri Lanka, and also senior officials of the government, senior members of the security force for Jaffna Airport development project, which is going to commence development of the country, and in this respect, now province in a very fast and effective manner. So air transport, many decades, would be very important. So in this respect, I like to recall that in terms of the cabinet decision taken by the international airport. Why we call it a regional airport is this. The runway currently is capable of 2400, which has less than 80 seats. Now such aircraft have a range of about 900 kilometers. When we
my side to me. Now the question of other than the passengers going through these, getting directly and indirect benefit. Now other airports, other countries where there are regional airports or international airports in other provinces, there is a tax sharing system. Now airports, all airports have a tax.
What can you all do from your side? Those are the things we were looking at this particular meeting. I think when I do my speech, I will tell you what are the plans when it comes to the government, what we are going to do. But what we need you all to do is to try and see how you all can get involved, do most of the business from the north rather than pushing it to Colombo.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Senadi Raja, Mr. Sumandiran and Mr. Siddharthan from Parliamentary colleagues, G.A. Jaffna, my secretary, head of institutions from our ministry, and heads of military forces and the police, the members from the government institutions, ladies and gentlemen. At the outset, I would like to thank the Honorable Governor for organizing this meeting in a very short notice. When I phoned him and wanted him to get some of these stakeholders relevant to the airport and aviation business, he was very keen to be part of us, to help us to try and get the airport into the next level. We have done a small plan. We have decided if we get the clearance from the HE, the President and the Honorable Prime Minister, we are looking at October 16th to do the opening. So we want the construction will be over by the 10th. My target is to try and open on the 16th, or 16th is a Thursday, which I personally feel it's a very auspicious day as far as we are concerned and even the North people.
It's not your birthday,
no? No, not really.
What is January?
It's a long way to go. I want to start that. That is the reason we thought we will come and have a dialogue with you all, and there are We brought all the institutions relevant to the ministry, to the airport. The customs, immigrations, intelligence, all the relevant institutions are here with us, and they saw the importance of this airport. And I think DG has given a clear picture what we are planning to do.
phase-wise, phase 1, 2 and 3. And what our major plan is to see what sort of business we will get in the first couple of months. Depending on that, we are looking at the phase 2 and phase 3. I personally feel this is something we as a government promise to the people in the north. And I'm sure that the politicians who represent the people in the north have been requesting this for last so many years. I'm not talking about anything else. I was given this job about 6 months back. From the day I took over, Honorable Prime Minister has been pushing all of us to try and get this on the track. And even, I have to say, the President has been very closely monitoring what we are doing and how to develop this particular airport. So I would like to thank both the leaders of our country, actually the President and the Honorable Prime Minister, for pushing us to get this thing on the track. And as far as we are concerned, I wanted to thank the heads of forces, and they have been very supportive of us for a lot of issues we had. There were a lot of issues which we couldn't handle it, and I wanted to thank the Army, Navy and the Air Force and even the police for the support given in the last couple of months for us to come into this particular level. And I'm not talking about my own institution like Airport Aviation and the authority, because that's part of our job. And what we are looking at to try and get people in the north to try and travel to see their relations or friends in South India in a very short period. I have seen this when I used to travel. There were people coming from the north, almost traveled about 8 to 10 hours by road or train, go to the airport at least about 3 to 4 hours before, and travel 1 hour, 1.5 hours. So they have been suffering for so long. And that is one reason when we took over this government, we were very keen to get this airport as soon as possible. And now that we are on the fast track, by the 16th, we are planning to do the official opening if Honorable Prime Minister and HE, the President, gives me the green light, whether they are free. I wanted to get both to try and come and open this airport, because this is, I won't say it's a political promise given by both, but this is something they are very keen on, see whether this will initiate when they are running the government. And I don't think I have to discuss about some of the other things. I personally prefer to have a dialogue with relevant authorities, especially in the north, to see how we can be work together with you all, and for you all to be partner with us to get this airport into the second phase and the third phase. When the business starts coming in, that's the time we are looking at the second and the third phase. So we have already done the initial homework. I want to thank Saman Ekanayake, the Prime Minister's secretary. He has been one other person who has been very keen on this project. I'm sure that pushed by the Honorable Prime Minister. And even the Prime Minister, he used to conduct every week, he used to conduct a meeting related to this Palali airport matters. And once again, I would like to thank all the politicians who has been supporting us on this particular project and the governor. And whatever the support we need in the future for expansion and get to the next level, I would like to tell the governor and the politicians to give us the fullest support. We want this particular airport to be a proper international airport within about a year. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
And our officials to tackle this water issue as a crucial issue, because you can't run an airport without sufficient water. I mean, that's just a joke. So how are we going to get this?
We agreed then we will go to the western side, so that's all right. Already, I don't know whether you are aware, already there is a lot of opposition you know, people saying why is this going from this side to that side and all that. We're not too concerned about that, because the old Palali Airport concept and what we are going to now start are very different. We are using that previous experience that we had more than 50 years ago. The governor had flown from Kalambur. Are you 50 yet? he said 50 years ago he had flown from Kalambur to Palali, Palali to Trichy, and Trichy to Singapore in the same aircraft. He says, yes, Lord. So we have people with all their experiences, so it's good to remember that and reconstruct it. But what it is going to be, it's going to be quite a, you know, difference in answer. Therefore, we were not too faced about having the entrance from the western side, so that the least inconvenient to the Air Force, which is now located on this side. But on the western side, or rather the northern side as you call it, it's actually the northwestern side, the access to the airport, from what we were shown at the last meeting, there seems to be some deviations now. One is the issue on the if you can see from the on the southern side, that road. I'll first deal with that and then come to the road on the west. The road that runs from west to east on the southern, that goes through the airport perimeter. So there was a discussion on that, and there was a suggestion that you can actually round that and go. I think airport perimeter is like this. So there was this concern that this road can't be opened, and somebody said we can do that.
Around the bunch.
Right? Now, initially there was some resistance to that, but I think that is feasible. I'm saying this because, you know, people of this area, I represent all the people of this area, all the Vadaparachi, people of this area who used to access the airport this way here, are now going to be told to access it from the other side. So how do they, from all this point view to all of the area, how do they dare to travel around and come? So if the closest possible rounding is the best, so if this road is accessible, we can make the adjustment. We can make that adjustment and get to this. But now, today we are told that there is some issue here, exactly where I am pointing, on that road as well. Isn't that so? This, on this. Now, yeah. If the issue is one of having the road straight and that running into the perimeter, why don't we have it along the existing road? There's an existing road, no? This is this picture. This picture is not very clear. There is a small
curve here. There's a problem going
over
the normal the present road.
Yeah.
The other side is Palali.
Yeah.
That doesn't go through. No. That doesn't go through any private road or land.
No, private.
This is straight road. What is shown in the map is not the old road. What is shown in the map is the existing road that has been created to round the bund.
Yes.
And therefore, it is going through some private land.
Yes.
That's the issue, right? Okay. Alright, so that we need to resolve.
Nearly 5 acres or something.
So when I check there today,
yeah.
I went there and check,
yes,
there,
yeah.
But it won't affect the bund, even if you do the
road. It can sort the road. If that is so, then we have to resolve the issue, no?
One thing I want to tell you,
yeah,
is there's one bund and this is
a separate. Yeah, you might have a small gap there.
It doesn't affect the, you
right,
can explore the possibility.
Right.
Otherwise, yes, if you have to pull it back, it,
yeah, then there will be an issue.
Level. Right. Left part of the cantonment.
So that is one. Then the other is, now the access road that you are building is somewhere here, is it? Like
from
this.
From Mylady Junction.
You see, no?
Council Junction.
Can go. What he is saying is bund is not the boundary.
Okay.
There,
yeah,
is,
yeah,
a little more.
Yes.
There is a little more,
yeah,
right? So that is understandable.
Yeah.
So, but I am only asking whether some, in some way, these are not too many spaces. know, it's about, as he says, about 20 meters or so. So if some adjustment can be made, or even if that part, some little part of the land to be acquired, start the process of acquisition. It's impossible.
Chairman,
actually,
have you identified whose land is that now?
No, DS knows.
Identify that land. No. Only 20 meters, 20-40 meters within the road.
If acquisition is the way, it's a small strip,
yeah.
Right? Whose land it is? Is it DS? No. Is this an old acquisition area? No.
No.
To acquire the land, I think that is, let us go.
And on the south also, do that around your bun, yeah. And finish it off.
Honorable Minister,